Dr. Babar Khan, Sara mentioned here plastic, and that brings the imagery of the ocean to one's mind. Now, predictions are that by 2050, there will be more plastic in the oceans than fish. How did we get here?
Yes, Michelle, pollution in general is a big environmental issue and obviously a huge threat to the marine ecosystems in particular. And plastics constitute around 60% of the marine pollution. In case of Pakistan, a larger part of plastics is generated from the land, but unfortunately that's being dumped off in the rivers, and Indus River being the second largest carrier of plastic to the Arabian Sea. Unfortunately, there are no easy and simple solutions to manage the plastic pollution, particularly when it comes to the oceans, but there are certain challenging options available where we can try to manage part of the plastics from the oceans. For instance, you know, ghost nets. Nowadays, there are, you know, monofilament nylon nets available in the market, which are being used by fishers very extensively. And such nets, after once or twice being used in the fishing practices, are often discarded and left freely in the ocean, which not only catch some of the ETP species and they get entangled into them and die, but more often these ghost nets, when are left freely in the sea or ocean, sometimes, you know, really damage the corals, reefs, and other marine habitats. So we have been working with the fisher community here in the coast of Sindh and Balochistan to collect some of these plastics, particularly with a focus on ghost nets, to collect and bring them back to the coast, where some of the female communities, you know, females from the local communities, are converting them into some useful stuff like harnesses for donkeys and some other things. Right. Collection of plastic bags from the surface is a bit easier, but once the plastic is drowned in the sea, its collection becomes really a daunting challenge and very difficult task for people to collect it.